Hi, my dear children. Welcome back to your Max class. Hope all of you are doing well. Today, we are going to start the first chapter, Angles. Let's start our class. In this chapter, we are going to learn measuring an angle using a protractor, drawing an angle of specified size, and drawing geometric figures using the idea of angle measurement. Do you know what an angle is? When two lines meet at a common endpoint, an angle is formed. The common endpoint where the two lines meet is called the vertex, and the two lines are called the arms of the angle. An angle is denoted by this symbol. Unit to measure an angle is degree, and is denoted by a small zero. This degree symbol is placed at the top right corner of the number or the measurement you had taken. Here is a 90 degree angle, and the 90 degree is shown like this. Next, types of angles. The main types of angles are right angle, acute angle, obtuse angle, and straight angle. Now, we shall go in detail different types of angles. First one, right angle. If the measure of an angle is exactly 90 degree, then that angle is called a right angle. A right angle is having square corners. Next, straight angle. If the measure of an angle is 180 degree and is formed by a straight line, then that angle is called a straight angle. Next, acute angle. If the measure of an angle is less than 90 degree, then that angle is called an acute angle. Next, obtuse angle. If the measure of an angle is more than 90 degree and less than 180 degree, then that angle is called an obtuse angle. Next, measuring angles. Now we are going to measure an angle. Which instrument is used for measuring an angle? Yes, it is the protractor. The protractor is in the shape of a semicircle. It is divided into 180 equal parts. The protractor has two sets of scales in it. They are the inner scale and the outer scale. Both has measures 0 to 180 degree in both directions. Now, let's measure this angle. The midpoint of the baseline is called the center point. Place the center point of the protractor over the vertex of the angle and place the base exactly on the baseline of the angle. Now look at the arm of the angle that points to 0 on the baseline. It points 0 on the inner scale. Then we need to measure the angle on the inner scale. Now look at the other arm of the angle. Yes, it points to 70 degree in the inner scale. Then the measure of this angle is 70 degree. Is it clear for you? Now, let's measure another angle. Here, the center point of the protractor is over the vertex of the angle and it is placed over the baseline of the angle. Now, measure this angle. What is the measure of this angle? Here, the other arm of the angle touches the 90 degree of the protractor. Then, the measure of this angle is 90 degree. Is it clear for you? Next, naming angles. Here is an angle. How will you name this angle? Yes, it can be named as angle ABC or angle CBA. Keeping in mind that the vertex should be at the center. Is it clear for you? Now, how will you name this angle? Here the vertex is K. Then the name of this angle is angle IKJ or angle JKI. Is it clear for you? Here is a homework activity for you. do this in your textbook. That's all for today, children. We shall continue our class on the next day. Okay? Thank you.